When I first started my acting career, I had zero experience. I mean, we all start with no experience, right? 12 years ago, I didn't know anything about acting. In fact, at the time, I was still trying to pursue a career as a software developer. But then I started taking the necessary steps that would eventually lead me to where I am today. I've now worked on dozens of movies and television shows. I've had the incredible opportunity to work with multiple Oscar-winning actors, multiple Emmy-winning actors, and some very well-respected directors. And I've been able to do all of that even though I had absolutely no experience when I first started. So that's what I want to help you with today. How can you do what I was able to do? How can you become an actor with no experience? Let's get started. What's up, my fellow actors? Welcome to the Acting Career Center, here to help you learn the skills you need to break into the film and television industry. My name is Kurt Yu. Thank you so much for spending some time here with me today talking about your acting career. I would love for this to be a conversation, so I'd like for you to answer a couple questions for me down in the comments. The first question is, why do you want to be an actor? Why do you want to be an actor? What is it that inspired you to become an actor? Was it a movie that you saw? Was it a television show? Was it a play that you saw? Or was it a particular performance by an actor that you were mesmerized by? Who was the actor that inspired you? Answer that question for me. And in a separate comment, answer this second question. What are your acting goals? What is it that you hope to achieve in your acting career? And feel free to tell me as many goals as you want. And think big. In your wildest dreams, what are your goals? I'll tell you one of mine. One of my biggest acting goals is to be in a Star Wars movie. I've been such a fan of Star Wars when I was a little kid, and then all the way through my adult life, I've been a fan. So, hey, if they want me to play a Wookiee, if they want me to play Chewbacca's cousin, I'd be happy to do that. I'm probably not tall enough to play a Wookiee, but I would just be so thrilled to be a part of Star Wars in any way, shape, or form. So let me know what your goals are. And if you need to pause this video to answer those two questions, then go ahead and do that, because these answers to these two questions are so important and they will actually play a major part in how you approach your acting career going forward. So today we're talking about how to become an actor with no experience. I have been in that position before. I know exactly what it feels like to be a brand new actor who doesn't have an agent, doesn't have any credits, never did an audition before, and I was able to start from there and then build my career step by step to where it is today. I'm now a working actor with over 50 IMDb credits, including Netflix shows, Marvel movies, and Disney projects, and many, many more. And I don't have any family members in the entertainment industry, so there's no nepotism happening here. It's all about taking the right steps and putting yourself in the best position to succeed. So I want to share with you the steps that I took. I want to help you get to where I am and hopefully beyond. Sound good? Hey, if this is your first time here, make sure to subscribe to this channel to get more videos on acting, auditioning, and career advice from me every single week. And also, don't forget to check out my website. I have other free resources on there for actors as well, including my free 10-step audition preparation cheat sheet that'll help you nail your audition every single time. If you want to download that free cheat sheet, you can do it by clicking that link right up there. So one of the questions I asked you earlier was, what are your acting goals? And your answer to that question is actually going to determine whether or not you should continue watching this video. Because look, if your acting goal is to make acting your hobby, if your acting goal is to just have a lot of fun with it and go make some fun movies with your friends, shooting it with your iPhone and put them on YouTube, that's great. And if you want to do that, then you can go and do that right now. You don't have to take any more steps to do that. It's like me with tennis. I really enjoy playing tennis, and I like going and playing tennis with my friends and having fun doing it. I have no desire of making tennis my career. I have no desire of pursuing tennis professionally, right? So I don't have to take any future steps. Same thing with acting. If you just want to do this as a hobby, then you can go and do that right now. If, however, you want to make acting your career, if you want to go anything further than doing it as a hobby, if you wrote down in the comments that you want to work on big movies, big television shows, you want to work on Netflix or Disney or HBO or anything like that, if you want to win an Oscar, right? anything beyond it being a hobby, then you do have to take some necessary steps. The first step to starting an acting career is to take acting classes. And there are plenty of acting classes that you can take. Here's a list of some classes that I would recommend. You can write these down if you want. Technique classes, scene study classes, improv classes, on-camera classes, voice and movement, accents and dialects, weapons and combat, script analysis, and audition classes. Now, there are plenty of others as well, but these are the ones that I would recommend any actor start with. This is the very first step that every single actor must take, and it cannot be skipped. You cannot skip taking acting classes. You can't just get an agent and start auditioning for movies and television shows. It doesn't work that way. And it's not because you're not talented. It's because you gotta give casting directors and agents and directors and producers a reason to trust you. You gotta show them that you're serious about this as your career. I'll use an example here. Let's say you were playing a sport and you broke your arm and you needed surgery. And I came and told you, hey, I'll do the surgery for you. I never went to medical school. I never learned how to do a surgery, but I'll do it for you. I'm confident that I'll do it. Are you gonna trust me to perform surgery on your arm?
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Or would you trust someone who went to medical school? That's the point here. You gotta give them a reason to put their trust in you to cast you in their project. That is only one benefit of taking acting classes. Another huge benefit of acting classes is that it will build your network. In this career, the more people that you know, the more people that know you, the more chances that you will have to succeed and to move forward in this career, because you're building a community when you go to acting classes. I can't tell you how many times that a fellow student in an acting class emailed me and said, hey, I saw this audition that you fit, and they sent it to me and they told me to submit to it. And I've done this for other people too. I've seen auditions that would fit a friend of mine and I would send it to them and tell them, hey, check this out, you should audition for this project. And it's not just the students in the class, it's your teachers too. I've gotten so many opportunities from my acting teachers. Bunch of my IMDb credits for movies came from projects that acting teachers or other students recommended that I audition for and that I eventually booked. So this is the real power of a network, and a network that you can build by going to acting class. This is why I've continued to go to acting class for 12 years. I've been taking acting class every single year my entire career because I know how much it benefits my career. And it's not just the stuff that I learn in class, improving my technique, improving my acting ability, which is extremely important, but it's also the network that I'm building, the community, the tribe, the acting tribe that you gain by going to class. After acting classes, the next step that every actor needs to take, especially if they want to start auditioning for anything, is to get a professional headshot. Your headshot is your most important marketing tool as an actor. It's the first thing that anybody in the industry sees of you, so it's extremely important to make a great first impression. This is another step that you just can't skip. If you're trying to pursue acting professionally, then you have to get a professional headshot. If you want agents and casting directors to take you seriously, then you have to show them that you are taking your career seriously. You want them to have confidence in you, then you can't give them a picture that was taken on your iPhone. So how do you find a good headshot photographer? Well, ask the people in your acting class. That's another great benefit of your acting class, is that you have people to rely on to give you advice. I can tell you who are some good headshot photographers where I live in Atlanta, but if you don't live where I am, you're not gonna come all the way here to take a headshot. So you're gonna wanna ask the people that are in your city who you can go to get a great headshot. So a great place to ask is in your acting class. So those were the first two steps to starting an acting career before you go out on any auditions. You gotta go to acting class, you gotta get a professional headshot. Now let's talk about three more steps that every single actor needs to take. The first one is to start finding auditions on your own and start auditioning for projects. You gotta be able to do this yourself before you get an agent to do it for you. And next after that is learning how to self-tape. So most auditions these days will request you to record your own audition at home instead of going live and in person. So you gotta learn how to record it at home, and that's called a self-tape. You gotta be able to do that as professionally as possible. The third thing is to finally get an agent. Every single actor, if they wanna pursue their career professionally, will eventually have to get an agent. And you might ask, well, if I can find auditions on my own, why do I need an agent? Well, the thing is, most auditions for big movies and television shows, you will never be able to find on your own as an actor, because they are only sent to agents and for the agents to pass on to their actors. Last year, I was able to find, I think, 5 or 6 auditions for big movies and television shows by myself on sites like Actors Access. And do you know how many my agent found me? Over 100. So I was able to find 5 or 6, but my agent found 100 more for me. So that's why it's so important at some point in your career that you will need to get an agent. So those are 3 more steps that you will need to take. I'm not gonna go in depth into each of those because I actually have individual videos on each of those 3 topics. I have a video on how to find auditions on your own and submit to them. I have a video on creating a great self-tape at home, and I have a video on 4 ways to get a talent agent. So I'll put links to all 3 of those separate videos down in the description below. I will also put a link down there for another video that's called The Cost of an Acting Career. And in that video, I break down how much each of these things that we've just talked about will typically cost you. So how much you should expect to pay for acting classes, for headshots, how much you should expect it to pay an agent, all of these things. So that link will also be down in the description. The last thing that I want to share with you today are a few words of inspiration and encouragement, and those words come from you. Those words come from the answers that you gave to my 2 questions earlier on in this video. Why do you want to be an actor, and what your goals are for this career? Lean on those answers anytime the going gets tough in this career, because it will. This is a really tough career to pursue, and it's not for the faint of heart. There's gonna be a lot of heartbreak, and that's why you really gotta love it in order to do this. You talk to any famous actor right now, and they will tell you there have been times early on in their career where they thought about quitting. Every single actor in this career thinks about quitting, and we need to push through that. We need to never give up. And one way that you can make sure you don't give up is that anytime that you start feeling low and feeling down about this career, is always think back to why it is that you really want to become an actor, and think about those goals that you have for yourself and keep pushing forward. All right, that's it for today's video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, leave those down in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, make sure to do that right now. And until next time, keep practicing, keep learning, and I hope to see you on set one day.